This week on Maker Update, Plastic Fantastic, a mechanism for every page, an art studio for the road, and more electronics books than you can shake a stick at. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we search high and low across the internet to find all the amazing projects that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all doing great and staying creative. We've got an exciting show for you, so let's get it started with the project of the week. How fast can you make a piece of 3D printed plastic go? That's what Xyla Foxlin is trying to find out in her latest rocket build. An all 3D printed rocket, and she wants it to break the sound barrier. You could almost excuse this as an ad for Bamboo Labs 3D printers, and they do play a significant role in the creation of this rocket, as well as being a sponsor for the video. But there's still plenty of opportunity for Xyla to flex her engineering prowess, and it's wonderful to see. The rocket is printed entirely, from nose to tail, in carbon-reinforced nylon, or PPA-CF. In fact, everything but the motor, the flight computer, and the parachute are all 3D printed. It's also a fairly small rocket, what looks to be 2 inches wide and a little over 3 feet tall. The body is essentially just a tube to contain the motor, and the motor is doing a lot of the hard work, holding most of it together. The rocket's name is its own source of joy. Since it's all 3D printed in carbon fiber, the name Spaghetti Carbonara just felt right. But when launch day came at the Friends of Amateur Rocketry site, things didn't go as hoped. It made its way off the launch pad just fine, but had a mid-air incident and loss of signal. And after combing the desert, they weren't able to find and recover any of the pieces, so they never learned what happened in mid-flight. Deflated, but not defeated, Xyla created a second rocket, named Mock and Cheese. Suspecting that the 3D printed body delaminated in mid-flight, she's applying a thin layer of epoxy resin over the outside to hold everything together. This one is also a shorter rocket, meaning there's less opportunity to flex and snap under atmospheric pressures. Mock made a successful launch and landing, but Xyla realized she forgot to drill vent holes in the nose cone, which slowed it down. But thanks to the kindness of strange rocketeers and a donated motor, she was able to make a second launch. And after a bit of archaeology to recover the flight computer, she got the proof she was looking for, Mach 1.5. It's a fun journey and a testament to the quality of parts that can be made with conventional 3D printing. More projects. From AxelMadeIt, we have this fantastic concept for an all 3D printed book. It not only introduces you to various mechanical mechanisms and linkages, but it also demonstrates how they work. In just a few pages, he's able to show off a Geneva mechanism, a Scotch yoke, an escapement, and plenty more. Every page is powered by this tall pinion gear that runs through each of the pages. He built this clever hinge mechanism so that only the current page is driven by the pinion. The final page is the first one he designed, revealing all of the electronics that bring the book to life. Then onto linkages, gears, and the first page is a bit of an overview. It's a gorgeous project with a lot of clever design considerations. Martina from Nerdforge loves to paint, and sometimes she loves to do her painting on location, for inspiration or just to better replicate her vision. But bringing your canvas, your easel, and your other paint supplies on the hiking trail is a bit of a pain. Her plan begins with a bicycle trailer, and the idea is to build a structure around it that looks like a mini cottage, but the roof will lift up and out to reveal her painting supplies, canvas, and maybe a few other supplies for the road. And don't miss out on her technique for adding texture and detail to these flat plywood panels. It looks just as good as anything she's made in foam, but it's actually structural. The roof mechanism lifts up on this synchronized series of pulleys turned by this ratcheting hand crank. Then the entire roof hinges upward and an easel folds down for in-situ painting. It's a super fun project with loads of creative storage and aesthetic considerations. Check it out! And for the 42nd episode of Greig Johnson Making, he's embarking on making a working prop of The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy from the book of the same name. He's not trying to make it screen accurate to either the film nor the BBC series, but instead he's mining the text for any description offered, and then just expressing himself from there. His design is notably retro high-tech, but also rugged and chunky. Also worth noting that most of this is made from found objects. No 3D printing, just chopped up bits from the junk drawer. The whole thing was created to be a prop in a short film of one of the most famous scenes in the story. And finally, last week I got to experience Submergence at the Rochester Fringe Festival. This is a massive walkthrough light sculpture created by the art group Squidsoup that involves hundreds of strands of addressable colored lights. In practice, it's like standing in a massive volumetric display while a semi-linear illuminated narrative plays around you, accompanied by an ethereal electronic soundscape. This is an older project that dates back to 2016, but worth checking out if it makes a stop near you. Time for some tips and tools on Instructables from Gokux. I found this design called the Cam Claw, a gripper for your robot or just to use on the end of a stick for picking up hard to reach things. As the name implies, what makes this special is that there's a small camera at the back of the gripper and an array of LEDs to light up dark places. And it's all self-contained and wireless, making remote operation easier. And I bet you could probably integrate this into some computer vision applications so a bot can know when something grabbable is within reach. Humble Bundle has a new book bundle out called Electronics for the Curious by No Starch Press. This is a pay what you want bundle, but it is arranged in tiers. To get all 21 DRM free books, you'll need to spend at least $36. But if you don't need to add that much to your reading haul, there are cheaper tiers available. It looks like there's a ton of great stuff here to amuse, instruct, and inspire. And the charity involved is the Electronic Frontier Foundation. Also on Instructables from Mike and Myrtle, there's a guide on how to restore and upgrade an old drill press. Whether you've bought a used tool that's been well abused or your drill press just isn't working the way it did when it was new, this is a helpful guide to restoring worn out tables, repainting, replacing your motor, and adding lights and safety features like an emergency cutoff switch. Maybe your drill press doesn't need this many bells and whistles, but I'm sure there's something you can use here. And from Do As I Do, we have a guide on how to make silicone molds from silicone sealant. I've heard of this technique before, but I was a little dubious about the process. And apparently the trick is to dilute the silicone with mineral spirits so it flows easier. In this example, they're making a mold of this flat Aztec calendar and brushing on thin layers to build up the mold. So this may not work for intricate figures, but worth trying out. And it might save you a few bucks not always buying casting silicones. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're taking a look at an older and shorter series by Shawn, a beginner's guide to 3D printing. While the technology keeps advancing and becoming easier to use, there are still a few fundamentals that are necessary to know, especially when your prints start failing. This series covers all the different technologies for 3D printing currently available, and how to best set up your machine for success. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.